Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name's Leigh Fuge and I'm here with mgrmusic.com, and today we're going to look at 5 Stevie Ray Vaughan style tips, tricks and techniques. For the video today I'm using my early 1980s Tokai Strat. A Strat is essential if you're chasing that Stevie Ray Vaughan style sound. This guitar is plugged into the Blackstar Studio 10 6L6, which is set to a clean tone. Now again, a 6L6 style amp is essential when you're chasing a Stevie Ray type tone. The amp is mic'd with an Aston Origin condenser mic, and I've also got an Ibanez TS9 Deluxe Tube Screamer on the floor in front of me for the overdrive that you hear in this video. My voice is being recorded with a Rode Go clip-on microphone. For this video, my guitar is tuned down a half step to E flat. This is the tuning that Stevie Ray often used in his studio versions of tracks. Technique number 1 is a Stevie Ray Vaughan style walking blues shuffle. This is a really interesting way to spice up your 12-bar blues progressions and add a really cool Stevie Ray style flavor. Instead of just sticking on a chord like a typical shuffle, Stevie Ray will play the chord, or just the open string to imply the chord, and then a series of notes that follow that. So here's the series of notes that we're going to be playing. So starting off with the open low E to the 3rd fret of the low E. Then we're hitting the 2nd and 4th frets of the A string. Coming up to the 2nd fret on the D before walking backwards, 4th and 2nd frets on the A, and land once more on the 3rd fret of the E. In a typical 12 bar, we would play the 1 chord, which in this case is the E, for the first 4 bars of the progression. That riff there takes up 2 bars. So to fill the first 4 bars of a 12 bar, you need to play that riff twice. Where we can make this really start to sound like Stevie Ray is when we start to put a rake in between each of those. So in between each of those notes, we're going to do an upwards muted rake from the high E back to the low E, like this. Now that was played pretty straight. To really get the Stevie Ray feel, we want to play a triplet feel here. So we're going 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a, where the picked fretted note lands on the 1, 2, 3, 4, and the rake lands on the So we're going 1, a 2, a 3, a 4. It's very much a shuffle kind of feel. What made Stevie Ray's playing really interesting is he wasn't even playing it like a straight triplet shuffle like that. He would delay it a little bit more so it has a little bit more of an urgent feel. So don't worry if it's not super, super tight on the beat. It can be quite loose, and that almost adds to the feel of the pattern. When Stevie plays these kind of shuffles, he wouldn't just typically go up and down with the strumming. He would actually move his hand in this circular motion. So you'd hit the fretted note on the way down, and then his hand would sweep around on the muted notes on the way back. When we move to the A chord of the progression, we're doing exactly the same thing, but we're using this series of notes. So that's the open and the 4th fret on the A string. The 2nd and 4th on the D string. And then we're coming backwards then from the 2nd on the G, 4, 2 on the D string, and land back on the 4th fret of the A string. So again, that makes up 2 more bars. And then the 7th and 8th bars of a 12 bar are back to the 1 chord. So we do the E pattern twice, the A pattern once, and the E pattern once more. The 9th and 10th bars are a bit of a turnaround. So what we're going to do here is we're going to use a B7 chord and an A7 chord. And I'm also going to play this B flat note here on the 1st fret just to walk between them. So I'm going to keep that shuffle feel going. It's a bar of B7 and a bar of A7. On the 4th beat of the B7 bar, I'm going to hit that B flat note, and then I'm going to do an entire bar of A7. So that's going to be like this. Then the final 2 bars, we go back into our 1 chord again, but this time we're going to put a little lick on the end. So that time we started off the same. The first half of it was exactly the same as it was first time around. So after we hit that second fret note on the D string, we come to this little run up, open 1-2 on the A. Then we play the second fret on the A again before doing this quick open hammer on to the first fret and pull off again on the A string. This is implying the flat fifth, which is the blues note. This is something that Stevie Ray did a lot in his playing. And then we land back on that G note on the third fret of the E string. And then that sets us up perfectly to go around for a second time. So here's that progression in full. Stevie Ray Vaughan style technique number 2 is a major third trill. Now, if we think of our minor pentatonic scale, so we'll do this in the key of A now, just because that's a nice easy one to visualize. The major third occurs on the 6th fret of the G. So when we play the 5 and 7 on the G, that's the minor third to the 4th. This note here in the middle on the 6th fret is a major third. So Stevie would put this major note in over his progression. So here's an example of a type of lick that you may see this in. So this lick is just a nice, simple minor pentatonic lick, but it's got a triplet feel. So we're going 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4. So the lick slowly is a full step bend on the 7th fret of the G and the 5th fret on the B and E strings. That's your 1. The second beat is a full step bend and release on the 7th fret of the G, the 5th fret on the G, and the 7th fret on the D. The third beat is this trill from the minor third to the major third. And then on the 4th beat, we land back on that 7th fret of the D string. And you can slide that out. The third Stevie Ray Vaughan style technique is this little half-step flurry that he does from the root note to the minor second of whatever key you're playing in. So here's a lick with that technique involved. So you'll notice that lick started off pretty similar to the last lick. We did the same ascending phrase to start. And then here's where that lick gets a little different. We then hit the second note in the minor scale, which is the B note, so that's the 7th fret on the E string. Then we got our little hammer-on pull-off flurry from the A to the A sharp, before landing on the 8th fret of the B string, which is a G note. So we're not really hanging on that A sharp for too long, we're just implying it. So that's still played with a triplet feel, so it's 1, 2, and the third beat is the 5th on the E with the 8 and the 5 on the B. And then the 4th beat is a full step bend on the 8th fret of the E. Lots of vibrato there too. Fourth Stevie Ray technique we're going to look at is these dyad chord triplets. So all we're actually doing here is playing two very simple dyad shapes. The first one is the 12th fret on the B string and the 13th fret on the G. And the second one is the 15th fret on the B and the 16th fret on the G. You can also add the open high E string as a pedal note here. So we've got this is a great way to create a nice, interesting texture because you've got that E note pedaling against the key of the song and the dyads which are moving against the E note. You don't have to put the E note in. You can just play the G and B strings if you want. But I think the E note really adds a nice, interesting Stevie Ray texture. So once again, we're playing that with a triplet feel. But what you can do is at the start of each triplet, you can slide it up a semitone. This gives it a little bit of a slide guitar type feel. So here's the full pattern, nice and slow, and then we'll play it full speed. fifth and final Stevie Ray Vaughan style technique we're going to look at is an open string pentatonic lick. Stevie used a lot of open strings with his pentatonic scales, so here's the lick we're going to learn. So this lick uses the first, second, and third shapes of the E minor pentatonic scale coupled with a bunch of open notes. We're once again playing a triplet feel. On the first beat, we're sliding from the third to the fifth fret of the B string, keeping that triplet feel intact, and we're hitting the high E string to pedal against this. We're doing this for the first two beats. On the second beat, we're sliding backwards from the fifth to the third, and then we're doing a quick pull off to the open B string. That high E is still being rung against it. And then we're landing on the fourth fret of the G with the B open. You want to really push that slide so it's nice and quick. Then on the fourth beat, we're doing the same technique. We're sliding from the fourth to the second on the G, push that slide, pull off to the open G, but keep that B note pedaling against it. And then we're going to land on the second fret of the D string. Then at the start of the second bar, we're doing a hammer-on from the open to the one on the G, and then we're playing the B and E strings open. Like those slides, you want to push that hammer-on there. It's still got a little bit of a triplet feel to it, but you're not playing a note in the middle. Then the final thing we're hitting is just after the second beat, we're hitting the 7th fret on the E and the 8th fret on the B, and giving them a little bend. So here's the full lick nice and slow, and then we'll play it full speed. There you go, there are five Stevie Ray Vaughan style techniques you can put into your own playing straight away. Like I said, don't forget I am tuned down half a step, so if you're trying to play along with the examples, you'll need to retune your guitar to E flat. You can play this in standard tuning, but just for the purpose of this video and authenticity against what Stevie does, I have tuned down half a step. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope you've enjoyed those Stevie Ray Vaughan style techniques. Let us know in the comments down below if there are any other artists you want us to dive into the techniques of. Don't forget to check out PMTV UK on YouTube for more free lessons just like this one. And if you're looking for a guitar teacher in your local area, please check out mgrmusic.com. We've got a network of great teachers all over the country just waiting to help you guys out. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you soon.